Thank you. Hi, I'm John, and this is an Omegamon model kit. Huge shout out to my friend for letting me build this for him, however good or bad it might turn out. Alrighty, let's get started. Beginning with the head that he already started working on, he accidentally broke off the connection point to this little horn, and sort of gave up and said, I'm done. Using a little bit of super glue, we can secure that bad boy back in. And then we can get started with the rest of the build. For a little extra background, after he broke off the horn, the kit went back into storage for a while. And once he saw that I was starting up my channel, he offered it to me to build and keep. But instead, I'm going to give it back to him as a completed project. So hopefully he likes it. I'm still working on my skills and cleaning off the nub marks, but I think this kit does a pretty good job in putting the cut marks in places you won't really look at. I'd say the build for this kit is pretty simple and straightforward. This is only my third kit so far, but compared to something like my HG Moon Gundam, which you can see me panel line in the short in the top left corner, I can definitely notice that the legs feel a lot more hollow and creaky. It doesn't take away from the appearance of the model kit at all, but when I do try to move the joints, it really made me wish it had an internal skeleton for that really smooth articulation. Here's the final build out of the box. I think it looks really cool, but I'm going to try to panel line it and see if it can make it even better. Now to take it back apart so that way we can gloss coat the kit. As a new Gunpla builder, I just found out that while putting this kit together, that you should gloss coat the kit prior to using Tamiya panel liner. To protect it from cracking and becoming a little bit more brittle, as well as to improve the liner's capillary action. If this was something I was building for myself, I'd probably just skip this step altogether, but because this is for my friend, I decided to go all out. After finishing up the gloss coat, now it's time for panel lining, but we're going to do something a little different. As fans of the 1990s Digimon the movie version of Omnimon, my friend requested to see if there was a way to give him a red outline, just like how he does in the movie. So I'm going to use some pink-brown Tamiya panel liner to see if I can try to emulate that. I tested it out on several pieces prior to putting on the kit itself, and it worked out pretty well. And I think so far it looks pretty well here too. Another tip that I found out after putting this kit together was that I could have done panel lining with the Tamiya panel liner prior to putting the kit together while it was still on the rails, and that would have prevented some of the concerns with cracking or brittle plastic. I didn't know it at the time, but it's good to know going forward. While I expected the pink-brown panel liner to work well on the white sections, I was pleasantly surprised at how well it worked on some of the darker colors, especially some of the gray parts. Now that we're finishing up here, it's time for cleanup. And now that that's over with, time to put on some finishing touches by super gluing some of the pieces that might easily fall off. Something that really bothered me about this kit was the sword. I hated how it was white plastic and they expected you to use decals to make it look like a piece of metal. I took it upon myself to paint the entire sword a metallic silver acrylic paint to make it hopefully look better than if I used a decal itself. I had no intentions of painting in the center part of it, so instead I cut out the center part of the decal with an X-Acto knife to put it out in the middle. Now to apply the decal in the middle. Lastly, I gloss coated the entire sword to lock the decal in place. While I was there, it was time to matte coat the rest of the kit using Krylon matte spray paint. I really enjoy a matte coat on these kits because it really gives a more premium feel to the finished product. Now that we're done with that, it's time for the final build. And here's the final product. Overall, I'm really happy about how this turned out. I think the matte coat really gives it a premium look, like I said before, and that the red panel liner worked out overall. And I guess most importantly, I hope that my friend likes the way that his kit turned out. Otherwise, I'll just have to buy him another one. Thanks everyone for watching. If you liked this video, please leave a like and subscribe, and let me know your thoughts in the comments. I would especially love tips on how I can improve my craft. If you want to watch any more of my stuff, check out my other videos. I have some other projects and figure unboxings in my hobby room. Thanks again, and I'll see you guys in the next one.